Reverend Fathers, ladies and gentlemen, my name is Jorge Vegen, and on behalf of the Faculty of Theology here at the Nicolaus Copernicus University, I'm honored to welcome you all for this international conference on St. Thomas Aquinas and the Fathers of the Church. There are both new and familiar faces here in the room, and that's partly because this is, in fact, our third conference on what is being called biblical Thomism. That is to say, the relatively new interest in Aquinas' use of scripture in his oeuvre, and in particular in his biblical commentaries. A renewed interest which aims at overcoming the typically modern gap between biblical exegesis and speculative theology. Our first conference in 2015 studied St. Thomas's biblical hermeneutics in general. And in our second conference in 2017, we explored this topic somewhat further with a particular emphasis on his moral theology. It soon became apparent that scripture and the church father are distinct but not separate sources. Because it's through them that one is able to have access to the correct sense of the biblical text. In fact, for St. Thomas, it goes without saying that guarding or conserving sacred scriptures also entails guarding or conserving those who have conserved sacred scriptures. A quote from his commentary on the divine names: one ought therefore not only to conserve that which is handed on in sacred scriptures, but also that which is taught by the sacred doctors who have conserved sacred scriptures in their integrity, end quote. St. Thomas is therefore far removed from the criticism that, to use Hans Urs von Balthasar's expressions, that the patristic autumn represents an ideological disfiguration of the fresh green leaves of the biblical spring to which one should return. For why should we deal with the muddied waters of the church fathers when we can have the pure water of revelation? Why do we need a river when we go to the very source? St. Thomas would find all these questions in the end unintelligible, for the transmission of revelation is for him not a passive event, once initiated by a deistic God, but rather, and in particular as Sacra Doctrina, a participation in the knowledge of God and saints, a provident God incarnated in Christ as mediator. At this point, I would like to welcome His Excellency Monsignor Andrei Suski, who's the former bishop of the diocese here and former chancellor of our faculty. Thank you for your presence here. Dans le monde académique, on a parfois, et là, je dirais, l'impression ou même l'inclination à penser que la lingua franca est la langue anglaise. Cette perception entraîne parfois d'oublier les recherches innovatrices dans le monde francophone, particulièrement dans le domaine de notre colloque. C'est la raison pour laquelle nous sommes très honorés d'avoir avec nous nos collègues, le révérend père Serge Thomas Bonino, le docteur Martin Morard et le docteur Giuseppe Cotticello. Je vous remercie d'avoir accepté notre invitation. So here we are at the beginning of our conference on Thomas Aquinas and the Fathers of the Church. And because it's always good to begin with the beginning and not to make a mistake at the beginning, as Aquinas says, so we start with Aquinas' sources, and it's my honor to introduce to you our first keynote speaker, Dr. Martin Morard. Dr. Morard is historian, theologian, liturgist, specializing in the history of the Psalter, the Latin Bible in the Middle Ages, and medieval biblical exegesis. He is researcher at the Centre National de la Recherche Scientifique in Paris, where he directs the project Glossae Latine Omnes Scripturae Electronicae, which aims to provide an electronic edition of the Latin glosses on the Bible. Together with Dr. Giuseppe Conticello, he also directs the Catena Aurea Electronica project, which aims at establishing an electronic edition of Thomas's Catena Aurea. Among his many publications in this field, I should particularly mention his article or a small book, because it's over 150 pages long, Thomas d'Aquin, Lecteur des Conciles, in which he meticulously traces St. Thomas's knowledge and use of the councils of the early church. His lecture is entitled Catena Aurea Electronica, Nouvelle Perspective sur la Catena, Son Histoire et ses Sources à la Lumière de l'Édition Scientifique en Cours. Dr. Morard, à vous la parole.